Okay, you guys pretty much well know how I am. I don't accept the old ways of doing things just at face value. I always try to find a better way of doing things. And I'm not satisfied with the old method of how people determine the transfer port size and the height, which determines the port duration. They went by the time area charts, and let's look at one or two. This right here says for transfer ports, the seconds per square centimeters, which is basically time area. The area increases with the engine size, and the seconds or the milliseconds increases by the RPM. So they're basically just going by the size of the engine and the RPM of it. And that is from Two Stroke Tuner's Handbook by Gordon Jennings. And there's different websites, and like this one just boils it down to giving a transfer port duration depending upon the maximum RPM, assuming that the side-to-side area of the ports is going to be the same from engine to engine, degree-wise. So we all know that in a two-stroke engine with the typical porting arrangement, the intake flow goes into the intake side of the cylinder, up the back side, across the top, and down towards the exhaust port. And that's known as Schnurl porting. Schnurl is the last name of the guy, the German, that invented that design or that setup. So I was thinking that maybe what people have unknowingly been trying to do is to get as much intake charge in there as possible without too much of it going out the exhaust port and without it being so slow because the time area of the port is so large that it doesn't even reach the exhaust port by the time the piston closes off the exhaust port. So that was my line of thought, and I wanted to explore that. This 360 degree circle shows as the crank rotates, if it's 180 degree exhaust port duration, it will open the port here. And a typical transfer open duration is somewhere around 120, 125, and the transfer is open here. So this amount of time right here, the transfers are open, and for all this time, the exhaust is open. So I have this example of a torque and horsepower from a customer I was working with, helping him design a pipe. And it goes to an Aprilia RS125 that was bored out a little bit. This right here shows the pipe boost from his pipe, his homemade pipe. So this is the pipe boost right here. And this is the graph of the torque that shows on that dyno. And this is the graph of the horsepower that shows on that dyno. So I figured out that the pipe boost would have to be about 30% to keep the normal torque curve without the boost fairly flat. And so this shows what the boost would be without the pipe, you know, like if you have a scooter pipe which just has a header and a muffler, and the horsepower without the boost. I know some people think that expansion chambers double the power. It's possible, but most of them don't. So I needed to know that percentage to be able to put the right numbers in a spreadsheet that helps me with this. This is the spreadsheet that I just recently made. And it starts off with a time area that depends upon piston speed, crankcase compression ratio, and the distance of that loop flow. So you see, from the start, I'm just throwing away the engine size, basically, even though the engine size affects the loop distance. And from that, I jump into figuring out the loop distance, the speed of the piston, and incorporating the crankcase compression ratio, which usually is about 5 to 7 psi when that transfer port opens. And in case you're new to two-stroke technology, the pipe boost happens as a result of the suction diffuser wave increasing the intake, or at least preventing the rising piston from creating a suction in the crankcase that pulls the intake charge back down into the transfers, and a positive baffle wave that causes a pressure at that exhaust port when the piston's rising and pressurizing the gas within the cylinder, which will tend to want to go out of the cylinder through the exhaust port. And so this rising pressure right here counters that tendency to go out the port. So the combination of boosting the intake and preventing the intake charge loss out the cylinder gives you a pipe boost for like 3,000 RPM at the top. You know, without the boost and with the boost, it's still fairly flat. And that's what the program is showing out here, a fairly flat boost, which is basically, you know, your delivery ratio is how much of the intake charge is retained in the cylinder when that port closes. And it pretty well directly relates to torque. If you increase your delivery ratio, you increase the torque, you increase the horsepower. Torque is basically the engine power for each cycle. And horsepower is a result of all those cycles compressed together more and more with higher RPM. So the red graph right here is the horsepower. And this graph is backwards. It starts at high RPM and goes to low RPM. So I know you're thinking, what the hell? Why is the horsepower going down? It's going up because the direction is this way. I probably should reverse that, but I've already worked my ass off to get this program to working right. And then the horsepower needed to increase speed is not a linear graph. It's something like if you double the speed, you have to triple the horsepower, you know, and that's why you see it curved right here. And so this asks for the bore and stroke, the end RPM of the pipe power band, the crankcase compression ratio. If you don't know that, just make it 1.5 because that's pretty much an industry standard. Millimeters over the transfer port, exhaust duration, millimeters over the exhaust port, transfer duration, the transfer port widths, the boost port widths, the angle of the roof of the boost port, and the millimeters over the boost port. And then over here you enter the type of exhaust pipe. Header with the muffler is a no boost pipe, which some scooters have. Some scooters also have a header that goes into a diffuser, which is an expanding cone, and then into a muffler. That gives a limited boost, but they're able to make the exhaust smaller that way. And then there's the expansion chamber for street and trail bikes and a racing expansion chamber. And then a row for custom numbers. If you use my pipe calculator, it on row 300 of sheet 3, it gives the numbers you need to put here. So just to give you an example to show how it boosts the torque and the horsepower. So I'm selecting the street trail exhaust pipe, and you see it boosted the torque and it boosted the horsepower. And this section right here is for if you know the maximum RPM that your engine is able to hold at any specific gear, and you're trying to increase that, what you do here is you change this number to move the needed horsepower graph so that it crosses the horsepower graph at the RPM that you know is the max. Okay, this moved it to the right. Okay. And this number out here tells you where at what horsepower those two are crossing. So this is like 9,200 RPM. And this is a made up engine. This is not a real engine that I've messed with. So it's just a generic example. So if I know that the maximum RPM is 9,200 and I want it to go up to 9,700, then this tells me, looking at the black graph, what the horsepower is at that RPM. And these are just reference numbers. They're not actual real horsepower numbers. They're just reference number. It's just something, a point of comparison. So in this case, it's 1.11. And at 9,700, it should be 1.17, which is a percent increase of 5.4. So then you could change the area of the port, of the transfer port. You can change the duration of it. And that directly affects the delivery ratio. But you would only want to do that as if this number out here was less than 1. This is showing that the porting arrangement that it has right now is enough to get the delivery ratio as much as possible. But if that was less than 1, then yeah, you would want to make some changes here. I'm selling this program for $10. And I'm giving it away to the first 10 people that request it. This is my email, just request it. And if you're past the first 10 people, I will let you know. And this is my Facebook forum, Two-Stroke Tuning Modifying. I only let people in by request. So let me know if you want in. So I guess that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Take care.